Good morning and welcome to the Church of the Nativity's Second Sunday Family Service. We're so glad you're with us. We have a handful of people here in person, and it's just a delight to see people here on our front patio today. If you're joining us on the live stream, we're glad you're with us this morning, Sunday morning, or anytime during the week. You are always welcome to be part of the congregation here at the Episcopal Church of the Nativity in San Rafael. This morning, Reverend Lynn is preaching and presiding, so we'll hand it over to you. Her son Carl is playing us music, and we have Angelina Paris reading for us.
Before we jump into the first song, I'll remind everyone that our prayers, if you have any prayers that you would like us to say during the prayers and you're not here in person, which it's lovely to see those of you who are able to be here, to type them into the chat function on Facebook, and my son will read them off during the service. So we definitely want everyone's prayers to be heard. And our opening song is He is Alive, and it is a lively song, and it has clapping, so just follow along with me. We've done it once before, but follow along with me if you'd like to clap along. So those of you who are here, I will say, please stand. Of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who in the Paschal mystery established the new covenant of reconciliation, grant that all who have been reborn into the fellowship of Christ's body may show forth in their lives what they profess by their faith. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Reading from the Gospel of John. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the authorities, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who is called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have to come believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There are very few gospel lessons that are read every year. Usually, as many of you may know, we have a three-year cycle of lessons. This is one of the few that is read every year. Now, there are so many ways to go with this lesson. There's so much here. But what I wanted to think about today is the statement at the very end of John's Gospel. "So that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing, you may have life in his name." John invites us with this statement to face our doubts, speak our fears, and yearn for more, more intimacy, more encounter, more experience of the living, breathing Christ. And he does it through the story of Thomas. Now, if you ask me, Thomas always gets a bad rap. When you were little, if you went to Sunday school when you were little and you heard the story of Thomas, what was it? It was like, don't be like Thomas. Don't be a doubting Thomas. But let's think about that for a while. Thomas just expresses what any of us logical, rational human beings would express. He's real. I was with my family once. My grandparents had a house in Hawaii, and we'd go there almost every summer. And at the beach once, the kids were in the water, and my mom just starts going like this. And we're like, what? So we all come running in, and she's like, "There's a shark in the water." And we're like, no. And we didn't believe her, of course, because we didn't see it. But we stopped and we watched. Sure enough, we saw that shark. We should believe her, even without having to see it, but we wanted proof. That's normal. It's natural. And then along came some surfers later, and we said, "There's a shark out there." They're like, "No, there's no shark." I'm like, "We saw it. There's a shark out there." We need proof sometimes. It's not wrong to ask for proof. Doesn't mean we'll always get it, because belief comes in as well. Thomas questioned. And what did the disciples do? It doesn't really say. But they didn't exclude him, because a week later, he was still with them. Even though he doubted, he was still with them when Jesus appeared again. He could question what they were telling him, and they let it be. They said, "You're still one of us." I think that's a big part of this lesson for us today. You can have questions and still belong. Now, I'm thinking of Angelina and Carl, who are going through confirmation right now. If you think about it, confirmation is about confirming your faith. It used to be, way long ago, part of baptism itself, but it became a separate process because there's a lot of reasons for that. But one of the things I think that's good about that is that young people such as Carl and Angelina can make the choice of what they understand and believe to be their faith. And we will confirm that, or the bishop will confirm that. They can ask questions. They can have doubts. And we can still say, "You are welcome here. You are welcome here." Because everybody's faith comes a little differently. Now, I know that when I was considering being a priest, and even still being a priest, sometimes I joke and say, I'm the worst priest ever. I'm not real studious. I don't read a ton. I can't really meditate very well. I get so distracted. Meditation, I always say, is not my thing. But there are parts of my faith that are very strong. And I don't have to be perfect. I am who I am. God created me a unique individual, just as he created each one of you as a unique individual who will live out your faith the way you are able to do it. And you will, at times, have questions, because life is not easy. Life is not simple. It doesn't matter. God wants you. Jesus wants you. Thomas's story reminds us that resurrection is hard. It was hard then, and it's hard now. It's hard to accept, hard to internalize, and hard to apply to our lives sometimes, especially when our lives are marked by pain, loss, uncertainty, or death, which are very real aspects of life. If nothing else, Thomas reassures us that faith doesn't have to be straightforward. It is a path, a way, and we all journey on our own. John's desire for his readers was that they would come to believe, that they would consent to the process, the path. The implication is that belief is not instantaneous. It comes as a gradual process. For some people, it may be instantaneous, but for most of us, it's a process. We are on the way, as it has been called. John chose an encounter between doubts and scars to help us come to belief. And this year, maybe more than ever, I am grateful. Because after the past 14 months of COVID, social isolation, racial injustice, gun violence, and political strife, this is territory that I recognize. Though we are a resurrection people, we are also a people in pain. The world around us is still wounded. And the scars we're carrying from this past year will likely last a long time. In these circumstances, Jesus' scars that he presented to Thomas resonate with me. Scars from this year. Thomas touching Jesus' scars and believing. What do our scars from this year tell us about our faith? Consider the implications of this lesson. We are a faith community that holds space for the wary and the skeptical. Every year, we share the story of a determined doubter who gradually found his way to faith, who came to see and believe in his own time. We too are individuals like Thomas. We may doubt, we may believe instantaneously, but we are on our own paths. And nobody but us knows where that will lead. We have a community, we have a Christ that help us in that process. But let us walk our own path and allow God to gently guide us or suddenly shake us closer to God. We have another song called Light of the World, and if you're here in person, stand up. Get some exercise. Sharing with God our cares and our thanks, saying, God, hear our prayer. For the speedy distribution of vaccines,
God, hear our prayer.
For Rebecca's grandson, my grandson who is turning 15 today,
God, hear our prayer.
And for the children and families at the border,
God, hear our prayer.
Pray for my brother, Rod, for quick recovery from his anxiety attack for the homeless.
God, hear our prayer.
Prayers for John and continued prayers for Fred.
God, hear our prayer.
Pray for continued healing from the COVID virus and for worldwide improvement for vaccines and good health.
God, hear our prayer.
Prayers for Steve Kenny and his family.
God, hear our prayer.
For Steve, Jim, and Mary.
God, hear our prayer.
For Helen's continued recovery.
God, hear our prayer.
Above all, we thank you for Jesus, his teachings to guide us, and his spirit to help us.
Amen.
Amen. All right, and this time we have our confession, and those who are here have a stone. And those of you at home, think of how soft your hearts are, and think of how hard they can get if you don't get rid of the things that separate you from God or hurt others. So we remember that as we pray, God have mercy.
God have mercy.
We have done things against you and against each other.
We have done things against you and against each other.
We have not done the things you want us to do.
We have not done the things you want us to do.
We are truly sorry and we ask you to forgive us.
We are truly sorry and we ask you to forgive us.
Help us to walk in the way of your love.
Help us to walk in the way of your love.
Through the waters of our baptism, God forgives us and sets us free.
Amen.
Know that you are forgiven and be at peace.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Oh, it is such a joy to be together. We will gather immediately after the service on Zoom, so please join us. We have the Zoom link on the homepage of our website, nativityonthehill.org, or in your bulletin. We gratefully accept your offerings today, pledge and donations. You can hit the Give button on our website, or there's an offering plate here. You can send in a check to the office. And then finally, we will share communion here with individually wrapped chalices and bread. But if you're at home, know that all of the benefits of Holy Communion are shared when we participate virtually. When we bring ourselves and our hopes to God together in this ceremony. So thank you for being with us, and let the service continue.
Thank you. Our offertory song is Lean on Me, which Carl will play and sing, but if you know it and want to sing along, the words are listed in your bulletin.
You're not strong, I'll be your friend.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. So we offer this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
O God, you are most holy, and we want to show you that we are grateful. We bring you bread and wine and ask you to send your Spirit to make these gifts the body and blood of Jesus, your Son. On the night before he died, Jesus was having a meal with his friends. He took bread from the table. He gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. Do this in memory of me." When the meal was ended, Jesus took a cup filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is my blood, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We remember Jesus' death and resurrection. Let us proclaim our faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Most holy God, because you love us, you invite us to come to your table. Fill us with the joy of the Holy Spirit as we receive the body and blood of your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Gifts of God for the people of God. And for those of you who are receiving communion here, I was warned you need to open the top with the bread before the wine, otherwise you're going to spill it all. Hymn during communion is an insert. It's hymn number 178 in the hymnal, but there it's an insert in your bulletin.
Jesus has God and has risen. thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name. Come, let us praise the living God, joyfully sing to our Savior. Alleluia, alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name.
Post-communion prayer is on page 6 of the service bulletin. Thank you, Jesus, for being with us once again through the bread and wine of communion. Be with us also when we leave the church today,
when we are at work, when we are at home, when we are at school, when we are with friends. Bring us to your table again. Amen.
And our blessing, which is so happy to see so many people I can actually bless, is we do in the form of a song, and we bless one another by making the sign of a cross to another. Since we can't touch, we can do that.
May the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you, may the Lord lift up his face to shine on you. May the Lord bless you.
And our final song is, some of you may know it, the music I gave Carl isn't the best, so if you know it, sing loudly. It's three different verses of the, it says the same thing in three different languages. One is English, which everyone I hope can get. The second is it Swahili?
It's Zulu.
Zulu. And then the third is in Spanish. So it's a pretty simple song, but let's go for it.
Walking in the light of God, we are walking in the light of God. We are walking in the light of God. We are walking in the light of God. We are walking, walking, we are walking, walking, we are walking in the light of God. Say, I'm a cookie nanny quick. 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 Say, I'm a cookie nanny quick.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.